Ey Leute, was geht ab? Wie eben versprochen, sitzen wir hier mit den Jungs. Der Reinach Rhymebreaker ist hier. Nice having you on the show. What's up?
Come on, I expand like gases. My sword slashes through the masses of these black ass rappers.
Ja, Christ.
What you gonna do, nigga?
We gonna get busy, won't time for your mind. Get busy, won't time for your mind.
Trigger the Gambler.
Fuck with your herd. Herd is a brown bear, wild killer.
Smooth the Hustler.
Smooth the Hustler.
Drug affiliated slash. Codename Hustle Specialist, strictly for that cash.
Nice having you on the show, man. Alles klar, die Jungs haben sich hier eben noch Klamotten ausgesucht. Wie wir es immer machen, wir fragen erst auf Deutsch, übersetzen es dann auf Englisch. First of all, we want to know where you guys from, for the peeps that don't know out there.
Brooklyn, New York.
That's Brownsville, right?
Brownsville. And my man from Shaolin.
Okay. So we thought about a couple of questions, and see everybody representing their where they're from, like Brooklyn, y'all talking about Brownsville. Why is it so important for y'all to let people know where you're from?
Because, like, basically, you know what I'm saying, where everybody come from out there, they're going to rap. It's all cliques in each area. It's Queens, Bronx, Manhattan, and Brooklyn. You know, and it's like up there, the radios, you know, it's the loudest clique that can make the noise. So when you're coming from Brooklyn, you got to set your town on map. You know what I'm saying? You got to put them on a map straight up. You know, so when you come with a clique like how we got it, we got Rhymebreaker from Staten Island. He still represents Staten Island, but he representing BK as well. You know, so if he represents Staten Island, we representing that too. You know, but you got to build where you from. You know, just to get that feedback from where you at too.
Meine Frage war, wo ist die Kamera? Die Frage war, warum es so wichtig ist für die Jungs, rüberzubringen, wo sie herkommen, wer ihre Clique ist. Und sie sagen, es gibt in Staaten gibt so viele Crews und so viele Cliques, dass du in jede Möglichkeit, die du hast, musst du nutzen, um dich selber zu repräsentieren, wie Markus immer Frankfurt repräsentiert zum Beispiel, um halt auch rauszustechen aus den anderen. Alles klar, hier immer noch, ist noch einer neu dazugekommen, Neutron, right? Neptron, sorry man. Nice having the show too. One question we thought would be interesting for the peeps out here in Germany. How y'all got to your names? I mean, it's not like a common name, like, my name's Tyron, I call myself Tyron, but y'all got like weird kind of names. Maybe.
Yeah. I mean, yo, I had so many names. I had names like K-Silk, Venus Flytrap. I had all types of names. So just like to sum it up in one big thing, we picked our names according to our attribute and just the way that we are. You know what I'm saying? Trigger, he got a bust your gun attitude. You know what I'm saying? When need be, Smooth, he's just real laid back. Rhymebreaker wreck the show. You know what I'm saying? And wreck something else if need be. And Naptron, you know what I'm saying? He's just spaced out in his own world.
You got to preach it or preach to y'all. You know straight up saying? And down, pimp it. Pimp the mic and preach at the same time. You know what I'm saying? That's how we get
I'm just,
down.
I'm the power absorber. You know what I'm saying? I absorb power, and that's and I just build off of that and just create monstrous things. You know what I'm saying? That's it.
I let my Marcus translate this.
Also Tyron hat gerade gefragt, wie sie zu ihren Namen kommen und zu ihren Attributen. Und das ist dann so ähnlich wie bei den Indianern. Wenn ein Indianer zum Beispiel kleiner Wolf heißt, dann ist es wahrscheinlich so, dass er ein kleiner Wolf ist. Er hatte alle möglichen Namen, zum Beispiel Venusfalle unter anderem. Aber wie gesagt, es ist so, dass ihre Namen halt zu ihrer Personality passen, also zu ihrer, wie sie halt so sind. Wie konnte ich Smooth the Hustler, man?
Smooth was, I always have Smooth. Smooth was my name. Then the Hustler part came in, when the struggle started. You know what I'm saying? Nah, but everybody got a little hustle in them. You know what I'm saying? Everybody a hustler regardless. 9 to 5, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, that's like natural. You know what I'm saying? Smooth the Hustler. It's cool too. You know what I'm saying? Short day.
Um da so ein bisschen Klarheit reinzubringen, wie Markus eben schon so richtig übersetzt hat, jeder, sein Name bezieht sich irgendwie auf die Person. Was ist Trigger? Weil er halt so eine Pistolenabzugsmentalität hat. Also er kommt halt krass, Smooth ist halt Smooth. Und der Hustler, weil halt auch mal schlechte Zeiten kommen und man gucken muss, wie man irgendwie weiterkommt. Wir gucken uns noch ein Video an. Es ist nie so einfach, mit so vielen das zu machen, aber ich denke, wir kriegen es ganz gut hin, Markus und ich, oder? Alles klar. Erstmal noch ein Video, wir sind gleich wieder da. Die wir von den Jungs hier gehört haben, war Hustlin' und Broken Language. Das war auf seiner LP, wo er gefeatured worden ist. I'm saying, like, the first stuff we heard over here was, like, Hustlin' and, like, Broken Language, like, where you featured him on your LP. So, and to me, it looked like it was kind of the unique style that made it, like, blow up and, like, stay up there for a while. So what makes the style unique? And I'd ask you to, you know, do something, little something for us right here so the peeps know what I'm talking about, if that's possible.
No doubt. I'm saying something right. Let me see. Check it out. Yo, Base your eyes on the guy. Vast, no kind of worries if I die. So why try? I danger feel stepping my way. Bodies get violated on a Friday to do or die way. Your death threater, cinder, head spinner, rap beginner, light dimmer, three knockout count winner, the steel reacher, lay him down teacher, your funeral servant church preacher, the rap hearse coffin seeker, the body polluter, gat shooter, the Brownville white Brooklyn trooper, the cock D mountain mover, the face basher, the lyrical brain smasher, the knowledge waxer, the Donald Trump the money stasher, body blaster, rhythm slasher, the human asthma, breath taker, body dump waster, the Glock cocker, the rock chopper, the shot popper, the jock cocker. Yo, it's this beat behind me, man.
Wie ihr gerade schon gesehen habt, sind hier also ein paar Leute. Why don't y'all explain to us, like, how y'all got together, like, how you work together, also with the two new peeps you got?
Basically, you know what I'm saying? Me and Smooth is brothers. Christ is my, you know what I'm saying? This is my best friend right here. Me and Christ been together since school, you know what I'm saying? Since junior high school. And we've been dancing and all that together, collaborating. Rhyme Record, we got with Rhyme Record like about, I say, and what? About 90, about 93. You know what I'm saying? It's been tight ever since. You know what I'm saying? And that's how it is. That's fam right there to the death. You know what I'm saying? This fam right here too, to the fullest, you know what I'm saying? All the way. This how we roll. Everybody we roll with in our clique is family. Straight up. We don't look at nobody as just like workers. This one a worker, this one a worker. Nah, it's not like that. You know what I'm saying? We build foundations, and that's how we survive. We live through each other every day.
SMG. Big up to the whole SMG, to the whole ruckus. The whole loan sharks, hill players, gun players, all that. You know what I'm saying? Around the world, we worldwide. For real.
International players.
Zur Frage, wie die Jungs zusammengekommen sind, also wie sich die clique eigentlich so zusammensetzt, ist, die beiden hier sind Brüder. Er kennt ihn schon seit der Schule, das sind die besten Freundinnen gewesen immer. Ihn kennen sie seit 93 und hucken sich halt gegenseitig ab. Und das Ding ist, es ist einfach, alle sind irgendwie gleichberechtigt, ist wie eine Familie, er ist dabei und jeder huckt sich halt selber, wie andere Crews das halt auch so machen. Nochmal ein Live-Piece oder ein Video, weiß ich jetzt noch nicht. Gleich sind wir wieder da.
T-S-O-M-I-O-G-O-T-T-E-H-E.
Smooth the hustler, trigger nigga.
It's that nigga trigger, smooth the hustler.
Customer serving first smuggler.
Smuggling drugs, serving customer.
DR period.
Period DR.
We are
we?
No doubt.
Doubt no.
Y'all see nigga.
See y'all.
Work up. Okay, wir sind zurück. World Cup. Die nächste Frage, die wir stellen werden, ist über das Rap-Business. Ob das wirklich so ist, wie Warren G sagte, 90% Business, 10% Show. Das fragen wir die Jungs einfach mal. Ich würde sagen, Tyron, translate es mal für mich.
Okay. The question we got is, to us it looks like nowadays, like the rap business, and I call it business, gotten like 90% business and 10% just, I don't know, philosophy.
What's up with that? We calling it 95% business.
95% even.
95% fun. Word.
Because even when you having fun, you still taking care of business, because in this game, when you go to clubs and stuff, you having fun, but you also politicking, you know what I'm saying? So it's still business. No matter if you sitting around laughing and joking, you might be laughing and joking with some top players right now, you know what I'm saying? And so,
but hold on. You think that's positive, or don't you think it's gonna like kill the spirit? In a way?
Truthfully, it is killing the spirit, you know what I'm saying? But if we keep them hard joints, you know what I'm saying, in the circle as far as radio play and all that, then it wouldn't, you know what I'm saying? Because it's getting, like, too commercial now, you know what I'm saying? And it's losing the feel of real hip-hop, and it's hard to get a real fat joint that everybody will rock to play on the radio, you know what I'm saying? It's hard to get that now, unless, and that's anywhere.
Unless you don't have the singing in it, you know what I'm saying, and everything like that. I mean, we do our thing like that, you know what I'm saying, but that's basically, you know what I'm saying, that's basically what them radios exactly want, you know what I'm saying? We trying to come different. We ain't trying to give them exactly what they want, you know what I'm saying? Because every time you feed somebody exactly what they want, you know what I'm saying, after a while, they don't want it no more, you know? So it's best to come out and give them something that we like to feel, you know what I'm saying? Like how we did Broken Language, my crew can't go for that, you know what I'm saying? That's something that we all sat down and collaborated with, you know, that we had in mind from a long time, like, yo, we're gonna always do a song like this to represent our crew, you know, we're always gonna do something different.
Then we're gonna translate this. Die Frage hat Markus eben schon gestellt, die Antwort ist die, dass ihrer Meinung nach ist es sogar 95% Business, was sie einerseits als positiv bewerten. Dann habe ich gefragt, ob es nicht auch ein bisschen so den Geist kaputt macht von Hip-Hop und von Rap. Und die Antwort war klar, was den Geist kaputt macht, ist, dass sehr, sehr viele kommerzielle Sachen jetzt auf den Markt kommen und dass, um mithalten zu können, muss man irgendwie da mitschwimmen. Das heißt, man muss eine Gesangshook reinmachen. Und wie die Jungs das für sich machen, ist, dass sie halt zwar dem entgegenkommen, indem sie ihn zum Beispiel singen lassen auf dem Track, aber trotzdem nicht genau das machen, was das Radio will. Nochmal ein bisschen Musik, danach sind wir wieder da.
Check it out. S-R-M-I-O-G-O-G-T-E-H-R-E Smooth the hustler, trigger nigga.
It's the nigga trigger, smooth the hustler.
Customer serving drugs, smuggler.
Smuggling drugs, serving customer.
D-R, period.
Period, D-R.
We are.
All we know,
down,
down, no.
Y'all see nigga,
see y'all.
Backwards and forwards, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. Check it out.
Alles klar, das war's auch wieder für heute. Ich würde sagen, wir verabschieden uns erstmal von euch.
Markus. Ciao, meine Freunde da draußen.
Ich liebe euch. Alles klar. It's nice having you guys on the show. Respect it. When you gonna be on tour? When you gonna be over here?
On, you know what I'm saying, on the next video that we drop, that's Broken Language 2, we're gonna be riding off that for a minute with the bus. You know what I'm saying? We still doing all the regular ones, the regular songs that's out there right now. We're gonna be running with those, so y'all pay attention. That's gonna go straight through from 96 straight through to 97.
And the album is in the stores. If it ain't in the stores, we're gonna make sure it get in the stores.
Y'all call up and request form. Yeah. Call them radio stations, call them stores and everything, you know what I'm saying? Them record shops. Act for Once Upon a Time in America. Life is a 50-50 gamble. Next Level Click, DVL is crazy.
Let me give a special shout out to my man Umar too. You know what I'm saying? Fat up Mom. At Fat Farm. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to you. Oh, and my homegirl Billy.
Also mit ganz kurzen Worten, wir sind alle Zeuge geworden von der amerikanischen Invasion auf Europa. Check it out. In stores now. Peace.
Und wir sind draußen. Nächste Woche 23:10 World Cup. Wie immer, machen uns locker. Peace.
Check.